I've been watching really smart people completely misunderstand and underutilize the basics of Bing Chat and other AI chat services. I want you to know what I know about the basics of how to get the most out of them. If you haven't been paying attention to AI, what I'm about to show you will have a foundational impact on your life. My name is Brian, and I've been a product trainer with Microsoft for over 10 years. And this is the first time, the only time, I've ever been overwhelmed and speechless by what a new piece of tech is capable of. So pause right now, and go to bing.com/chat, get it loaded up, or get the Bing mobile app right now so that you can follow along with me. Okay, the new currency, let's just call it prompt creation, okay? It's a new way to think about thinking, to think about ideas. So what is a prompt anyway? I think about it like this. To prompt is to coach, to mentor, to instruct, to invent. Do not think about this as a simple command plus response scenario. You're not a military squad leader giving orders to your team and then they just respond like you would think about a normal web search. What you are is that unpredictable, visionary Silicon Valley startup CEO who has all these great ideas but isn't so good with the details or the execution. But you know who is great with the details? Bing Chat. And if there's just one thing I need to land with you today, it's the immeasurable importance of the follow-up. The initial prompt should rarely, if ever, be your only prompt. If at first you don't succeed, tell it why you're disappointed. Let's hop in right now and see some realistic scenarios for you to try. Okay, here I am at bing.com/chat. The experience is very similar on mobile device as well. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in creative mode so it's more imaginative and conversational. So I'm gonna say, hey, what should I plant in my garden? A normal, everyday type of web search, right? Let's see what Bing comes up with. That depends on what kind of garden you wanna grow. It's gonna give me a list of a bunch of different options, which is great, right? It's being conversational like I asked it to be, and it's giving me some context for everything. Now comes the first of the follow-ups. I should have mentioned that I live in Utah. It's remembering what our conversation has been about so far. The response, oh, I see. Well, Utah has a diverse climate and topography. Okay, so now it's giving me more and more context to help me get more specific about my need, and I'm just conversing like normal with it. But we can do even better. I should have mentioned that my family doesn't like bitter foods. I see, okay, well some plants and flowers may have a bitter taste, such as these particular ones. We can go as deep as you want with this. What about, we love to eat Italian food. What recommendations would you have if I get that precise? And now it's giving me some fantastic recommendations based on this. So this is doing what the human brain really struggles to do, which is going out and finding a bunch of different resources, a bunch of different sources of information, and consolidating them into one easy, digestible, no pun intended, situation here that I can actually make use of. This is just incredible. But let's start over and try a completely new topic. You've probably seen different videos of people making poems and songs and stuff with these AI chatbots, but again, they're usually not going quite deep and specific enough. All right, let's say I'm hosting a friend's birthday party next weekend. My friend's obsessed with 90s cartoons. Can you help me make a 5-question multiple choice quiz that everyone in the party can compete against each other with, okay? This is a prompt, right? This is like, I'm giving it full context. I wouldn't ever go to a search engine with this kind of thing. This is like a conversation I'd have with another friend. But if I go to Bing with this very specific request, let's see what happens. Sure, I can help you with that. Here are some possible questions and answers. And look, it's saying the correct answer is A. Question 2, hey Arnold. Okay, I hope this helps you with your party planning. Have fun. That's amazing. But I'm not kidding when I say we can do even more with this. Wow, thanks. Can you also provide a points value for each question based on its difficulty level? The total possible score is 150 points. You can adjust the points if you like. This is stupendous. Now let's try to do something that you might do for like work. And I'm gonna choose more balanced mode for this one. So I'm gonna type out that I need to create an FAQ document for how to change the oil on an average car. What would you recommend for your top 5 FAQs that I should include? There's even a couple typos in there, but I think it'll be able to handle it. Sure, here's some FAQs. How often should I change my oil? What should the type of oil I use? Great, so it's giving me the questions. Now, can you provide a simple, easy to understand answer for each of those questions? Wow, it's even putting it in bulleted point format. So it's easy for me to just copy, paste, throw it in Microsoft Word, and make a printable FAQ document for whatever I need. But did you know that Bing Chat, right here in this same window, I can create brand new images? Well, Bing can. Let's say I'm making a YouTube video like this, or an Instagram reel or something, and I need a thumbnail image for it. And I just need it to be an image of someone using technology in an urban environment, and it looks really modern and high energy. But the overall vibe should be high energy and positive. And here I have the little progress bar as my image is being created by AI. And presto, here it's given me four options of what I've asked for. Look at this, I love the hat. Can you make it more in the style of vintage animation? Again, it's all about the prompt and the follow-up. And it's everything I asked for. A person, high energy, using technology, vintage animation style. Here I have my giant PDF for my dishwasher. Let's say that the dishwasher is overheating, okay? So I have the link to the PDF file. Help! My dishwasher is overheating. Based on the manual that I'm linking you to here, what should I do to troubleshoot it? Oh my goodness, I'm sorry to hear that. I'm looking at the manual you linked and found some possible causes and solutions. According to the manual, one possible cause is the water temperature is too high. The manual recommends you set your water temperature to another possible cause is overheating a dishwasher door may not be closing properly. It's reading that gigantic PDF manual and it's extracting the relevant information that I need. And it's based on the resource I gave it. Now, what about comparisons? This is the kind of search that people tend to do, right? And I'm not gonna say it's lazy, but what credit card is the best? Or best credit cards reviewed, you know, that kind of search. Well, here we go. You're gonna get some information, of course, from Bing Chat. It's gonna do its best to answer that kind of query. So it's giving me some practical advice. You know, there's a lot of variables. You might wanna consider the annual fee, the interest rate, all that kind of stuff, right? Yeah. Okay, great. Let's stop it responding and let's try something better because it's all about prompting. So here's my new prompt, okay? I don't travel often and I don't care about crazy perks. I just want to know which credit cards are good for someone like me who buys a lot of groceries for my household and has average credit. I don't want to pay a lot in fees. In fact, I don't want to pay any fees. Can you compare three credit cards side by side for me? Sure. Here is a table that compares some of the key features of credit cards that are out there. It created this table and it's comparing them based on rewards rate, bonus, intro APR, average, regular APR. It's giving me exactly what I asked for. It's basically behaving like a serious real world consultant that I just have access to for any of my life questions. This is truly incredible. We are at a monumental time in our history, in technological development. And I hope, just based on this small taste, that you see how transformative this can be for our lives. And I really, really plead to you to please get familiar with it now. It's only gonna get better. We're still at the beginning and look what it can do. There's only one thing left to do. Write me a quick haiku about the value of yourself. Bing Chat. Now, while it's writing that, next time you go to search the web for anything, try using Bing Chat first, just as an experiment. Bing Chat is your friend. It can search and create things. Just ask and enjoy.